All right, 2 minutes. I was told 2 minutes. This is going to be like, oh my God, I'm sorry. All right, all right, all right. All right, how beautiful does Nancy look tonight? Whoa, all right. Michael, okay. You look good.
You with all my heart and soul. Every day spent with you makes my life that much better, and for that I am forever thankful. I'm looking forward to all of our new adventures together, and I cannot wait to see what the future has in store. So lucky I get to marry my best friend. With you by my side, I believe anything is possible. From this day forward, you shall not walk alone. My heart will be your shelter, and my arms will be your home. Love, your soon-to-be wife, Nancy.
Nancy, I love you. I love you so much. You are my world, and I am so fortunate to have you in my life. It feels like we have been together for a lifetime. My world was missing something, and you were it. Let me tell you what I love most about you. You. Everything that is you. Your hair, your eyes, your smile, your family, your passion, your commitment, your loving touch, your amazing attention to detail, your laugh, your conviction, your positive attitude, and most of all, your heart. I'm truly happy and honored to have you in my life. Our love will last forever, and forever we shall stay. Love, Michael.
My dear friends, we have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister in this community. In this way, you will be strengthened to keep mutual and lasting fidelity with each other and to carry out the duties of marriage. And so in the presence of the church, I'm going to ask you to state your intentions. Michael and Nancy, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
Yes.
Now I'm going to ask you to state your intentions. I, Michael, take you, Nancy.
I, Michael, take you, Nancy.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
And Nancy. I, Nancy, take you, Michael.
I, Nancy, take you, Michael.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. What God has joined, man must not divide.
You look good. It's an honor to be Michael's best man. I'm so happy for him and thrilled to welcome Nancy into the family. I must confess, I didn't want to be Michael's best man, but he bullied me into it. Some things never change. It all started when he was my crazy, hyperactive younger cousin, and I was, of course, an innocent, scrawny, bony little kid. And he bullied the crap out of me. He even gave me a black eye. That's the cousinly love that we had for each other. But there were bonds too. We celebrated our birthdays together every year because they were so close together. The memories of him screaming, throwing a tantrum as we sang happy birthday every freaking year.
Right.
I'm happy Michael can make it here today. He had to work his wedding day around his school calendar, right, Nancy? Okay. Everyone knows him that knows he's always in school, and we hope he's learning new things. He better, because he's teaching now. Today he starts his new schooling in a new field, how to be married, and he better learn. I have to say, of all the choices he's made in his life, Nancy is the best one. Not only is she smart, beautiful, but she's also fun. She's certainly not freaked out when going out for a simple drink turns out into a full burlesque show during Christmas time. That's when I knew she was awesome. She took it in stride. Here's to the couple, Nostrovia!
Everybody here knows Nancy is smart and beautiful and funny and wonderful. But what you might not know about her is that she's a hopeless romantic, and she truly believes in the power of love. We would go on these walks and runs together, and we would talk, and she would tell me that she never thought she would find the person that shared all of her hopes and dreams, faith, and family, and everything that she wanted. And I would tell her that God will put this person in your life when he's ready, when you're ready, and when he's ready. And he did. And if you would have asked me, or Sheena, or Liz, to design the perfect man for Nancy, we truly would have picked Mike. Maybe a little shorter, but definitely we would have picked Mike. And their love reminds me of a quote from one of my favorite movies, Juno, which goes, in my opinion, the best thing you can do is find a person who loves you for exactly what you are. Good mood, bad mood, ugly, pretty, handsome, what have you. The right person will still think the sun shines out of your ass. And that's the kind of person we're sticking with. So to Nancy and Mike, wishing you a lifetime of love and luck, happiness and laughter, and always remembering that the sun shines out of the other's ass. Nostrovia! Cheers!